Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I have a nail art tutorial. Well, not really a nail art tutorial. I have a nail tutorial for you, but I just figured I'd start it like this face to face rather than immediately go on to the close up with the nails. Because this is a different kind of video. Quite some time ago I did a poll here on YouTube on whether you wanted me to do a video about the basics of acrylics and French tips and stuff in one video or in separate videos, and most people voted for separate videos, so here we are with the first video I'm going to do about the appliance of acrylic nails. I'm going to show you how I do my acrylic nails just as a basic thing, only using, you know, clear acrylic, no colors, no face, no French tips, just really the basics of prepping the nail, how to apply the acrylic, that sort of stuff. But I just wanted to start a video face to face because I wanted to say some things beforehand, and otherwise you would have just had these, basically the still shot of nails, for the first 3 minutes, which would have been kind of boring. Yeah. Anyway, after this we are going to go to a close up with a voiceover to really show you what I'm doing, obviously. But anyway, what I wanted to mention beforehand though is, first off, I'm not a professional. I'm a professional makeup artist and a postman. But I'm not a professional nail technician. I'm just, you know, self-taught, basically. Or at least I looked up YouTube videos and that's how I learned how to do my own acrylic nails. I don't do acrylics on other people. I don't get paid to do acrylics on other people or anything. I just do them on me for fun, just because I enjoy it. So keep that in mind. I'm not a professional. Also, in this video, I was using a brush that is completely ancient. If you see me struggling with the brush because acrylic is clinging onto it, well, that's why. I mean, I used a brush that is basically too old to still be used. That's just one advice I can give you beforehand. Make sure you have a good brush. I actually always have spare brushes. I'm just too much of a cheapskate to let go of the old brush. But yeah, if you do acrylics, you know when you're going to have to use a new brush, because it's just going to be annoying at that point. And lastly, as always, all the products I use will be listed below the video if you want to know exactly what I used. And that's all I can think of beforehand. So let's get on to it. Okay, we're gonna start off with, this basically. This is just a nail polish design, and this was a nail. I had a little accident with a mailbox, as usual. I'm just going to treat this like a full nail build and going to put the nail form on top of the reddish part so I don't get acrylic right over that. But other than that, we're going to ignore it because it does not look pretty. The nails that I want to redo, I'm just going to chop off with nail clippers and then I'm going to go in with a nail file. This is quite a rough bit because this is what I'm going to use basically to remove most of the product of the nails that I'm going to rebuild. And just the basic product, like the nail polish and the lifted bits of the nails that I'm only going to do a refill on. Those are much quicker. I do gotta say, if you're not comfortable with using a nail file you're gonna need a nail file. But if you're not comfortable with an electrical nail file, then don't use one. And if you want to get comfortable with using an acrylic nail file, what I did personally is I bought the absolute cheapest one I could find because it was very weak, so it was literally barely capable of doing any serious harm. And just practiced with it until it broke, and only then did I buy this one, which is a lot stronger. Basically, you just want to be careful with it because, you know, it's a quickly turning piece of metal with like sharp bits, and you don't want to get it over your skin and you don't want to burn yourself with the e-file. Just be careful with the e-file. Look up specific videos by actual professionals about e-files before using an e-file. Be careful with it. If you don't want to use an e-file, if I've scared you away, I didn't mean to. But you can also just do this with hand files. It just takes a lot longer, so there's that. But yeah, a hand file is safer if you're not sure you can handle the e-file. Then with a more, pointed bit, I'm going to go around the edges. Just to remove the product that's there. This one is a little bit more gentle than the nail, so it's safer to use like this. And I'm also going to remove all the lifted bits, so all the pieces of acrylic that are no longer adhered to the nail, because if I would put new acrylic over top of that, it wouldn't magically adhere to the nail again. It would just be a weak spot in the nail and maybe cause the nail to drop off. The acrylic nail, not the natural nail, but still, it would not be nice. You gotta remove all of that. Then this bit is a mandrel. It's very soft. You can even touch it with your fingers. I mean, there's no particular reason why you would want to, but it's possible, it's that soft. And I'm just going to blend the acrylic with the natural nail with this bit. This bit is fine if it touches the natural nail because it's so soft. Then it's time to remove the cuticles, or at least the bits of it that are on top of the nail. I'm using a cuticle remover. This is just a cheap one by Essence. It's pretty old, so the jars probably look different now, but anyway. Just put it on there, leave it on for a couple of seconds, and then you can use a cuticle tool. A wooden one is more gentle. I'm using a metal one because I'm a brute, but to each their own. But just scrape off all the bits of cuticle that are on the nail, because, like, you know, the lifted bits, cuticle bits on the nail can also cause lifting of the acrylic. And then I'm just using a cuticle bit on the e-file to remove even more. And then just, you know, remove all the bits that I've just made come loose. And obviously after this, go wash your hands, because you don't want to leave the cuticle remover on there for, like, you know, the rest of the day. Wash them thoroughly, dry them thoroughly, and then it's time to go build the actual nails. For this tutorial, I'm just going to use the Max Adhesion Liquid by Neo and their clear nail art acrylic polymer. And also their brush. Yes, it is the completely doomed and dead brush. I'm using a new one now, but my favorite type is the oval size 10. Not too big, not too small, and just the shape that I enjoy working with. And of course, in nail form, you can also use nail tips. Personally, I prefer nail forms because they just give you more freedom in how you want to build a nail, whereas a tip just looks as it looks. But yeah, to each their own. Then a nail prep dehydrator and a primer. But actually, we're going to start off with buffing the natural nail so the acrylic has something to adhere to. I'm using quite a rough file. You can use a much softer file if you're not a postman, and if you... Well, if your nails are weaker than mine, also use a softer one. Just check what works best for you, basically. And then for the nail form, if you're doing this on yourself, it's quite difficult to get it on sometimes. What I like to do is just make sure that I already sort of like shape the nail form before putting it on the nail. That just makes it a lot easier, because obviously you can only really use one hand to put it on, because you're putting it on your other hand. The hypernickium, the bit of skin underneath my nail, is quite grown out on my nails by nature. So I'm just chopping a little bit of the nail form just to make sure it can just fit nicely on my nails and I don't get a gap between the nail form and what's left of the acrylic that's already there. And always make sure, obviously, that the nail form is all nice and tight and in the right direction at the right angle. Because this is just going to decide how your nail is going to be angled. And I also squeeze it quite tight so it just gets a nice C-curve. That also makes the nail stronger. And it just looks nice. At this point, it's time to go dehydrate the nail. The dehydrator is mostly alcohol, so you know, you can just slap it on the nail, no problem. I'm just going to make sure there's no oiliness left. Obviously, I'm also going to do this on the nail where I'm just going to do a refill. And then the primer, and with the primer I'm using an acid-free primer. But still, you know, with an acid primer you need to be even more careful. But even with an acid-free primer, be sparse with this. You don't need a lot, you just need a very little amount. And you don't want to overdo it. And then time to actually start on the acrylic. Yeah, don't use too much monomer, your brush does not have to be soaking. And then just grab a bead that's about the size of what you need. I'm grabbing quite a big bead now because I'm going to start on making the tip of the fresh thumbnail first. At this point I realized that, seriously, it's so difficult to film this. Like, literally, I was almost stabbing myself in the face with the back of the brush at this point, just to make sure that I didn't stab the camera in the face. Or in the lens, rather. It's seriously difficult to film, so I'm really sorry for getting out of focus or just entirely out of frame a couple of times. I really need to practice at this because it's quite difficult to, you know, film this. Yeah. Anyway, about the nail themselves, do make sure, of course, that they're like equal in length with the other hands. Just looks a bit nicer. And then for the cuticle, always make sure to grab a bead that's one, not too big, and two, not too dry, because you really want it to get nice and thin at the cuticle itself. Also, don't go over the skin, because one, it's not good for your skin, and two, it can cause lifting of the acrylic nail. And lifting is right about the worst thing that can happen. Well, not the worst probably, but you know, it's not good. As you can see, there's still a little bit of a dip there at the center of the nail. So I'm just going to apply a little bit more acrylic there and just keep applying the acrylic until there's a nice shape to the nail. The shape really matters. You don't want it to be too thin in places. You don't want it to have, you know, very significant weak spots. You just want it to be all nice. Doesn't have to be absolutely perfect yet because we're still going to file, but you do want it to look nice, you know. And then much easier is the refill nail. I'm literally only going to put a bead at the cuticle there. Blend it out. Make sure I still have the nice shape of the nail. That is the thickest at the part where I want it to be the thickest. And that's just basically it. A refill is just really, really quick and easy. And again, just be careful to not get it over the cuticle. You can also use a pinching tool to get a nicer C-curve. I don't always do that because my nails by nature have a pretty strong C-curve, but you can if you want. This is a way where you can, how you can change or clean the brush, I mean. I just changed the brush after this video because my brush was just dead and doomed and like more than a year old at this point, so it was just its time. But yeah, you can clean your brush this way. Always make sure you clean it after every use if you still intend on using it again. By the way, like I said at the beginning, I'm not a pro at any of this, like this is just what I do. If you have any advice for me, like if you really see some glaring mistakes or whatever, feel free to tell me. Advice is always welcome, so feel free to tell me in the comments below. If you have anything that, you know, you think I should do better. But yeah, anyway, then for filing, I just go the free edges first, then the cuticle area, and then the surface of the nail. I gotta admit, most of that I learned off the Neo Nails YouTube channel. But yeah, I start off with a very rough file to really get the shape of the nail in there, and then I go over it with a slightly softer file to really make sure there's no weird bumps in it anymore, and to also remove some of the scratches that the other file might have created. And then after that I go over it with a buffer... That came out weird. A buffer? A buffing block? After which the nail should be perfectly smooth. Now, usually at this point I really do make sure to check if the shape is just, you know, good, because once you put on a nail polish you can't really change the shape anymore without ruining the polish, so make sure the polish or the shape is good before you hit the nail polish. I always go over it with nail polish remover or acetone afterwards to make the nail even smoother and also to make sure there's no grease on it. Because half the time I go eat lunch before applying nail polish for some reason. It just always works out that way for me. And yeah, then basically you're free to do whatever you want. Normal nail polish, gel polish. In the intro and end of this video, I was not wearing normal nail polish, but for this actual video, I'm doing gel polish. And as you can see, the other two nails, they still have, you know, an old acrylic design on them. So I'm just going to add top coat to that and just reuse the design, basically. So yeah, first just applying two coats of gel top coat on the nails that need gel top coat. And then all the nails are getting the gel sealer, the clear top coat. And then I'm gonna cure that and then we're done. As far as the products go, by the way, if you're using gel nail polish, just follow the directions on the bottle. Because, you know, one manufacturer might, you know, make their formula so that you need to cure it for 60 seconds. Another one might make it so that you need to cure it for 90 seconds. It can really differ per brand, so really just make sure to follow the directions of the specific product you're using. And also make sure, by the way, to wrap the tips of the nail. As you can see me doing here, especially if you've used gel nail polish, because you really want to seal it all. And then time for some cuticle oil. It's really important to make sure your cuticles are well moisturized, especially after all the chemicals we've used on it by now. I really just do this twice per day, actually. Not the gel and stuff, but only the cuticle oil. And then we're done. We just have the complete shiny, fresh nails. And here we have the final results. Yeah, basically what I always do after I've done my nails is just apply nail polish, like normal nail polish, gel nail polish, doesn't matter. This is actually four different nail polishes, normal nail polishes, five if you count the top coat. Anyway, yeah, that brings us to the end of this video is the point. This is just, yeah, this is just basically how I make my extensions to have my long claws. And I hope it was useful. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I actually mostly do makeup tutorials. This was also a tutorial, which I'll link somewhere up here. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.